In binding multiple devices to a pop-up, we've covered the simple case where the equipment hierarchy does the work for us, but that's not always an option. Maybe our equipment isn't named such that this is possible, as in a data floor where a given rack has multiple feeds from different panels. Or, in the case I'll use, a breaker is being monitored electrically by a meter, but the status points are coming from its digital inputs. I'll start by dragging out a button and attaching a pop-up snippet to it. I'll go ahead and change the link's name to Breaker Pop-Up. We'll create this page shortly. Now let's step through this script. It stores the name of the component, which is normally the equipment name being navigated to. It also grabs a list of the link objects in the component, as well as the component's GUID, which is required by invoke later. It also sets the title of the pop-up page using the component name. Next, the script grabs an attribute called substitute names, which does not currently exist on our component. This is the key to substituting multiple devices on a pop-up, and we will return to this shortly. Similarly, the width and height are set in the script, and the option to show the title bar. Interestingly, the script will attempt to invoke all links, but the engine will only run one, so we can ignore this loop. Finally, we come to the invoke function itself. This is documented in the system guide if you search for invoke function. All we do is pass the file to navigate to, then all the parameters we gathered above as a string separated by bars. Invoke handles all the details of substituting strings and opening the page correctly. Now we can return to substitute names. This is looking for a custom attribute containing a substitution string equals the text to substitute. Let me step out and demonstrate. I want to pass my breaker close tag, and I'll use input 1 on the utility main meter to simulate this, so let me copy that item. I'll give my button the new custom attribute substitute names. Name the substitution closed, then pass the tag. I also need the trip status on input 2, so I'll add a comma followed by the trip substitution. Any substitutions on the page that are not in this list will be replaced with the name of the component, so I can still click on the main to set the component's name. Now I can create a new pop-up page. I've already copied over the generic pop-up from PLS Include, but we haven't made any changes yet. As is, the page will map all points to the meter. The scripts in these components handle changing the values and indicators, including changing visibility if the binding fails. This is what we need to change. Recall that binding takes the component name and attaches the bind name below that. So to change this binding, I'll remove the component name and change the bind substitution to closed. Lastly, for historical reasons, the script is expecting the value 1 for open and 2 for closed. I'll change this to 0 and 1, respectively. I'll repeat the same for the trip status, but no script editing is required. And we're done. I can now save the page as Breaker Pop-Up as we configured in the button earlier. Back in the web HMI, clicking on the New button displays the standard pop-up with the meter's values, but the breaker statuses from the meter's I/O. I have a couple of remaining comments before we break. First, as we saw previously, substitutions work anywhere on a page, so this method can be used to pass any other needed parameters into a page, for example, the device's physical location. Second, this argument to invoke is just a string. You may find it easier to create multiple custom properties and build the string in JavaScript, or even build the string based on other properties in the page. The possibilities are endless. If you're interested, I'll walk you through one more advanced example in the next video. Otherwise, please continue on to something else. Either way, thank you.